Good morning and welcome back to our series on fundamental movement patterns. Today, as you can see, we will be addressing squatting. Squatting is frequently cited as the most fundamental lower body exercise. Squatting begins with a position of a flexed ankle, flexed knee, and flexed hip, and finishes in a position of full extension, so completely upright. So in terms of musculature, if we look at the posterior side of the limb, the glutes and the hamstrings in terms of their extensory aspect are going to be used in squatting. Gastrocnemius is going to be used to resist the flexion moment on the way down. We can see quadriceps here in front. That's our main knee extensor. So squats really do tackle all of the muscles of your legs at once. And the lower back, depending on how much it's loaded, is usually loaded in sort of an isometric way. Doing some squatting breaks up the pattern that's typically found, the sort of 90 degrees at the hip, 90 degrees at the knee, that we see when people sit for long periods of time. I am a big fan of addressing both extension and flexion, so meaning if a squat would be the flexion component, as you can see my hip, my knee, my ankle, these are all in something of a flexed position. That is what squatting addresses. Squatting translates into being able to squat, a resting squat like this, which lets you do things on the ground very easily. It translates into jumping. It translates into running fast, all kinds of skills that require explosive or endurance strength from the legs. Squatting is going to be your go-to. The distinction between squatting and lunging can dissolve in some cases. So if we're talking about something like a deep lunge where you've got your heel still planted on the floor, but your knee way out in front, that already is basically just a squat on the leg that's in front. The leg in back is getting a stretch. So as long as your programming includes some full range squatting and some kind of sort of big extended leg out and back mobility, you're not really lacking for anything. Most people cannot lunge more than they can squat. From a strength standpoint, squatting makes more sense as a skill, but there are a lot of one-legged style squats that sort of blur the distinction. So if we look at heavy step-ups, that already is sort of a little bit more like a lunge. We're stabilizing on one leg. Pistols are not a great example of that, for those of you that are more technically minded, just because pistols, you have one leg out in front. It's very good hip flexor practice. It teaches you some core stability, but it doesn't involve that big extended in the back mobility that people tend to get from lunging. I may do a separate video explaining this in more detail. Movements that I would use for lower limb training, squats are great. Hex deadlifts are close to a squat, especially if you manage to do them on some kind of a platform so there's a deficit and you actually can get low enough down there. You can use different variations of cable squats. You can do different variations of jumps. If you're trying to train for power, that's an especially useful way to do it. Squatting has immediate application in terms of things like explosive leg strength for sprinting, jumping. If you're learning to do single leg squats especially, it has a lot of application in terms of running. So aside from the fact that squatting also gets you to the floor on a daily basis, if you ever need to do anything on the ground, it's a lot more comfortable once you've mastered squatting to squat down than to bend forward for long periods of time. I hope that this helps you figure out what you need to do on a leg day in the gym or a squat day in the gym. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, leave them down below, and I will see you next time. Hopefully that went okay. I have no idea how that went because I could not see the screen.